So honestly, like the change from mechanical engineering, the broader world view to materials, like the smaller, like literally atomic world view.
The project that I'm working on with my AP Physics class currently is guided by a need to know question for the students of how can we successfully put a lander on the surface of Mars. During the final task, task five, where students did their drop and qualification tests, we had a number of engineers from Blue Origin and Boeing present and communicating with the students, asking a number of great questions.
Okay, what did the other designs look like?
This, okay. And this.
Interesting, yeah. How did this one hold up?
There's motivation for the students when the project they have connects to an actual real-world problem, and that they see or hear actual people that have a job that uses those skills. I try to make sure that they've got that connection, that they see, here's a person, we're gonna hear from them. They're applying the concepts that you're learning right now to tackle these real world problems.
I basically knew I wanted to be in the aerospace field since I was around your age in high school. It was basically when I learned that you could get a job building spaceships, and I was like, that's it, that's what I want
to
do.
Give the students a chance to really see if the language they were using and the concepts that they were trying to explain actually made sense to somebody besides me or a peer in the classroom.
Equations. The impulse equals force times time.
Right.
So if we change either force or time, the other one's gonna react if impulse is constant.
That's very insightful, that's good.
It helped that they were using some of the same vocabulary we were. It was kind of a connection of this is actually a thing that goes on.
And things can normalize your motion that you may have underneath that chute can mellow out some before impact.
If you manipulate time, the force also changes, and so that's how we've been changing the force.
There was a lot of great communication going on both directions.
Like hit and then crackle
and
the
then
eggs.
Directly. Okay, cool.
So.
And it sounds like you've done a little bit of testing to see if that works.
Yeah, we've done a fair amount.
The students able to understand what the engineers were saying back to them, and the engineers also seeming to be quite impressed by the ability of the students to explain their choices and the design of their landers using appropriate physics language.
We were really just focused on like the maximum air resistance
that
we could get.
We often struggle with the fact that we're trying to teach students knowledge for jobs that don't exist yet, and that's how quickly things are changing, especially in the STEM field.
As a mechanic, I learned a lot too, so that when I came into engineering, I was able to view things through a different lens. I knew how a machine worked. I knew how to program.
To have these engineers come in and say, this is what we do on a daily basis. These are the skills I wish I had developed more when I was your age, has a really meaningful impact.
Can we give a huge round of applause to all of our experts and guests for coming in today? Yeah.